over Christmas, we had a crazy large guinea pig population. At one point, we had about 21 guinea pigs here in the shelter that we were trying to rehome. Since then, we've been able to adopt many of those, but we still have about 8 on our adoption floor. The ones that have been there the longest are these two that we have on the show for you today. These guys are Frankie and Chase, and they have been in the shelter since September, which is really kind of a long time for them to have been with us. Over there on Tammy's lap, the white one with the red eyes, the albino, is Frankie, and he's an American guinea pig. And then on the outside is Chase, and he is the black and white, and he's an Abyssinian guinea pig. These guys are a bonded pair, so we will only adopt them together. When you do adopt guinea pigs from us, our standard adoption rate is $10, but when you get two, you get two for $15. Frankie is about 2.5 years old, and then Chase is about 1.5 years old. They're not siblings, but they weren't adopted at the same time, but they have been living with each other for over a year. So they are very comfortable and spend the majority of their time together. Frankie seems to be a little bit more outgoing. He'll come out and let you pick him up a little bit easier. When you're handling Chase, it's gonna be more of a kind of chase him around the cage a little bit before you're able to pick him up. But they, as you can see, they're perfectly content sitting on Tammy's lap being petted. It's important when you're taking home a guinea pig and making them part of your family, whether you're adopting them from us, which is always our recommendation, or you're buying them from a pet store, that you are giving them time to be handled and interacted with. You can't expect your guinea pigs or your rabbits or your hamsters to be friendly and outgoing if you constantly are just leaving them in their cage. Guinea pigs especially are very social creatures. That's why they do better when they have a friend. They like to talk to each other. They are herd animals. They're prey animals of all kinds tend to prefer to have a friend to keep them kind of company and let them know that they're safe, able to warn them when something's coming, things like that. These guys will talk to each other, but if you're getting guinea pigs that haven't been living together, you do need to slowly introduce them to one another. You can't just put two guinea pigs in a cage and assume that they're going to get along. It's a slow introduction process. If you're looking for more information about how to properly care for a guinea pig, we recommend visiting the Small Angels website. We provide all of our rodent, guinea pig, small animal adopters with information that we've gotten from their website. They have a lot of great resources that can give you all the information you need to know about cage requirements, how much time they need to have out getting exercise, what you should be feeding them, how you should be grooming them, any type of treatments that they require. It's going to be a great resource for you. When you're getting guinea pigs as well, you want to make sure that when you're housing them together, they are the same sex. Frankie and Chase are both boys because you don't want to have a bunch of little guinea pigs running around. If you are interested in these guys, you want to stop in and visit here at the shelter. We are again open to the public 6 days a week. You can visit any of the animals during our open kennel hours, which are Monday, Tuesday, and Friday from 10 to 5, on Wednesday and Thursday from 12 to 8, and on Saturday from 10 to 4.